Hi guys, I want to do this video. It's a bit different than what I usually do, but I thought it was quite important that I address this. And this video will be about my troubles with anxiety and how I'm using mindfulness to combat that and just try and live a happier, healthier life. I'm gonna try and make it quick, but no promises. I don't have a plan for this, so it might be a rant. So I'll tell you a little bit about my problems first. Sorry, it's a cat. Last semester, back up even further. Throughout my whole life, you know, I've had instances that have shaped me to be who I am, and some of those positive, some of those negative, right? Throughout high school, I had a lot of anxiety. Mostly because I just kind of overdid myself. I got involved in a lot of things, but I was able to manage it, and I did really well in high school. And I also did Running Start, so I went to the community college, or took community college classes while I was in high school. Then I came to the university, and things have been really hard. It's been a long process, and I've changed a lot. I will, just because it's freshest to me, I will tell you about last semester. Now, I've had a problem last year as well, and I feel like I may have SAD, which is seasonal affective disorder, yet I have not been diagnosed with that. It just feels like every single winter I get in this really just not a good place, and I'm here to share with you that. Last semester was really, really hard for me. Reflecting back on it, it doesn't seem that hard, but in the moment, I definitely had my times where I was in a pretty depressive state. For me, that means I just lost interest in my hobbies. I didn't really want to do anything. I ended up oversleeping a lot and missed several of my classes because either I overslept or I decided I didn't want to go because I just wanted to have fun in other ways and just not focus on school. The thought of going to class really stressed me out, and so I decided not to go, which made me feel fall even further behind. I just hated my major. I asked a lot of myself or asked myself a lot of doubting questions about life and my future. And it really just kind of put me down, and I had a lot of anxiety, and I put a lot of pressure on myself, I guess. let's see. So I also took advantage of the counseling center here at the university, and I kind of stopped going last semester when things were going well for me, but then as soon as I stopped, I would have, I had a lot of anxiety attacks, especially with it, while I was in class, which was really, debilitating to my learning, and I would have anxiety attacks when I came home, and really that just means for me, like a tightness in my chest and a swelling of tears, dreading everything that was going on, dreading school, dreading having to do all of these things. You know, it was very overwhelming. Now to kind of move on. So So after last semester, I had winter break, which is about a month long. And I don't know what happened during winter break. Maybe it's just because it was a nice break, a really long break, where I got to, you know, reconnect with my family, reconnect with my boyfriend, who's in I'm in a long distance relationship of 3 years. And so that was nice. It was kind of like a restart for me. And so at the beginning of the year, I made a commitment to myself to continuously go to the counselor because I was just at the end of spring, winter break, I realized that what I felt last semester, I did not want to feel anymore. Like, I was just so sick and tired of feeling bad, feeling sad, feeling just dread, you know, getting up and having to do all these things. And so I went to the counselor every week. I have not skipped one yet since, I think. And he's been really helping me. Like, I realized so much. So that's one thing. It's like, if you're in a depressive state or have depression, I've not been diagnosed with anything, or have anxiety or doubts, or just like constantly thinking negative thoughts, seek help. Like, what's the worst that's gonna happen? The worst that's gonna happen is that it doesn't, like, nothing gets better, and then you're just gonna be in the same place as you are right now, you know? And do you really want to feel that way for that long? No, I didn't. I realized as well that life is very short. Like, I know people say that all the time, but in reality, and this scares me, but I have to share with you, is like, in reality, anytime I get into a vehicle, like, what is the chance I get into a car accident? What's the chance that any sort of accident throughout your day changes your life in an instant, you know? So I'm really changing my philosophy about life and how I live every day. And I try and make every day special and realize that there's so much out there for you. So many, like, endless possibilities. You can make your life whatever you want it to be. As long as you... I don't know what's happening. The cat is, like, throwing things. Yeah. So, yes, there's a lot to do. And I'm lucky... She's just throwing things. There's a lot for you out there. And I just want to be happy. And it's not also that I want to be happy for me and my sake, my livelihood, my health, my mental health. It's also because, like, I've also got really sick of, like, calling other people or asking other people to come over to help me with my problems. And that came from a very lack of confidence and relying on other people for my happiness. So I'm also learning to just have confidence in myself and being an realizing that I have my own individuality, which is something I lost last semester. I definitely just felt very separate from myself and who I wanted to be. And so now, because I'm becoming more confident, I'm realizing I'm my own individual, seeing others that are successful and happy, I realize that can be me. I always doubted myself and thought, like, oh, that's, you know, that's them. Like, that's awesome that they're confident. Why can't I be like that? Well, I realize I can, but it takes effort and it takes time and practice. So what I have been practicing is mindfulness, which, because I have a lot of continual negative thoughts throughout my day, mindfulness to me helps me realize when a negative thought comes in that provokes anxiety. I can physically feel it, like a tightness in my chest, like a shallow breathing, just wanting to cry, essentially. Realizing that it's there, realizing that there's a negative thought, stepping back from that thought, like pausing and just thinking about that thought, thinking about it as if someone else was saying that to me and how I would react to that. Okay, so like, if I thought, for example, a lot of the times it's been like, I can't figure out this problem. Like this math, like I can't figure out this, or I don't know what to say. I'm not going to pass this class, okay, for example. So if somebody said that to me, I'd be like, no, it's okay. Like, you have these many, you know, this many tests to bring up your grade. You can talk to your professor, all these things. Now, those aren't really necessarily things that I would tell myself on a regular basis, which is really just strange to me that if I apply that to myself, I just wouldn't do it. Now, if I care for someone else, then I would, you know, help them through it. And I realize I can do the same thing for myself. So, one, I'm not going to pass this class, or I'm not going to be able to save up money. Stepping back and then realizing that my thought is a restriction on myself, which is a big part of what stems from my anxiety, is realizing that I have put limits on myself, because a big part of me is wanting freedom. It's ever since I was like a preteen and got my first sense of freedom, I've always just wanted to like be free, be my own person. And when I think of those negative thoughts, I really am limiting myself. And that's where I'm like, oh God, like, that's just a bad feeling. Like, I don't want to be like that. Like, I should be more open to other thoughts. So after I address it, then I step back, reevaluate it, apply reality. Like, what is the reality to that thought? What are alternatives that I can do to make this situation better or to make that thought better? I'm challenging those negative thoughts. And then I reevaluate and try to make a new thought and have a new feeling to that. And a lot of the time, it's been a boost of confidence, because I realize, I'm like, shoot, there's so many options. Like, I can, like, it's not as limiting as I think it is. You know, life is not as limiting as you may think it is. It's not black and white. There are so many things that you can do. And I'm celebrating my successes in this. How I've been successful in challenging those thoughts. And I'm turning out to be a happier person. The thing is, though, it's taken me months of practice, a couple months of practice. And this is something that I want to continue throughout my life. To manage my stress and manage my anxiety, manage depressive states. It's not easy, I promise you, because I failed a lot in the beginning. You know, my counselor would give me homework assignments to write down, you know, what my feelings are and how I challenged those thoughts. And I would come back each week. I'm like, yeah, I forgot to write it down, but I can remember. And he's like, But each week I've been at, like, a few weeks ago, I just wrote like one thing. And I told him about it. And then the next week, I wrote down three things that had happened during the week that I challenged, like thoughts that I challenged. And so it's just like building. And it's like not, it's also just not getting down on yourself about failing. Because that's also something that's just like, so hard on myself. High expectations. Shattered when things didn't work out, right? But again, if that were someone else talking to me, I'd be like, girl, don't get down. Like, you're okay. You have so many more, like, opportunities to keep trying. Try a little bit more, a little bit more. And it doesn't matter how much more, or maybe what the next week you step back a little bit and you don't do as well. It's like, that's okay. Like, at least you keep trying, right? Just keep trying. Just keep swimming, as Dory would say. Yeah, this is a lot longer than I thought it would be, and thank you for listening, and I hope that anyone who's going through a rough time, my advice is to seek out those who can empathize with you, and don't be afraid, because we're all, I know it's cliche, but we're all human. And there's a lot more people that will reach out to you than you think there will be. So have confidence, and I believe in you. but you have to believe in yourself as well. Have a wonderful day, evening, night, morning, I don't know. Have a wonderful week, month, life. And I gotta tell you, it feels good to be happy, so. Yay! See you guys later. Bye.